but that's the way that they want you to be. Locked up in this cage, you have a prison in your mind, trying to find a way to get free. Prescription drugs and television, that's not for me. You gotta fight it, don't lay down and die. You gotta fight it, don't sit there and cry. You gotta fight it, don't need to ask why. You gotta fight it, fight it, fight it, man.
Fight it we will. Welcome to UCY.TV, everybody. It's great to be here, and it's what a nuts day. Wednesday's hump day, usually dragging. It was like a Monday. Started off the day realizing that I lost my wallet. So therefore, scrambling around, doing all the things you got to do, lost a half a day's work, got tied up late, just through the door 30 minutes ago. I'm still covered in paint, but none of that matters because my guest here, and my guest is awesome. My first interaction with her was actually during the last show for Sia, and she called in with some horrifying information that I didn't even know, and my eyes are on the stuff that affects our kids almost daily, but she brought the reality that 19 states now still allow, the beating of our children if they are non-compliant in any way, and I was horrified. And Paula Flo, executive director of the Hitting Stops here, is live with us now. Welcome to the show, Paula.
Hi, Kevin. Thank you so much for having me on your show. I so am excited to be here.
Oh, it's the honor is mine. It's awesome, and it's amazing because, you know, you called in on that other show, and this is something we had never met before this. You know, it's something I didn't know that has to be addressed immediately. And, you know, the free spot in the schedule, I was going through the schedule change, hadn't got anybody lined up, and we were able to get you, and you made yourself available, which is even more incredible. I mean, I remain flexible, but most people are just under so much pressure, especially as activists, that usually it's like 2 or 3 weeks out, and you said, no, we'll do it at your first availability. And so I just want to let people know, normally we have the call-in available, and Paula may find a few minutes to take some questions at the end of this. But don't worry, folks, because we're assuming that there is going to be too much information for this 1 hour and that we will have to do a part two next week. So right now, formulate your questions. Just take it in. Paula's got a lot of information, and I'm going to zip it, Paula, and let you just take the lead, because I could go on for an hour without even thinking about it. So welcome to the show. Just start out telling everybody, you know, a little bio about you and your project, where it's going, what you need help with. Take the lead, please.
All right. Well, thanks, Kevin, and definitely interrupt me anytime you want to. I'm Paula Flo. I'm the executive director of this organization, which I started in, it was September 11th, 2006, when the Hitting Stops here in the U.S. paddling state of Georgia, which is where, after 27 years of my teaching with the USA school system, public school system, I had no idea that teachers were allowed to take wooden boards and beat school children for so-called gaining obedience. And I was in Georgia just for a little vacation. I took on a part-time position, and it was September 11th, my first day. And when I went to report it to the principal, she looked at me like, well, what's the problem? And long story short, I went to her supervisor, that person's supervisor, the school superintendent, the mayor, who was at that time Otis Johnson of Savannah, Georgia. And beyond that, everybody was looking at me like I had a problem until I finally reached a public school attorney in the city of Savannah. And he said, "Excuse me, ma'am, but this is what we do here." And that was the very moment that this campaign began, because I was horrified. I went home and did some research. At that time, I found that there were 21 U.S. states where teachers could beat kids with wooden boards, same ones as are pictured on old U.S. slave plantations that master used to use on the slaves. Many of them are huge with the holes in the boards, and they have small ones for kids in the USA who are in preschool, and they can beat you right on through senior year in high school. And believe it or not, even in some states like Mississippi, in adult education schools, under the issue of you are going for a high school diploma, therefore you must be treated like a high school student, and the rules that apply to them apply to you. So if you happen to be 24 years old and you still didn't get it, you know, you didn't do your homework, bend over. And a very recent case such as that took place, I think it was December 10th, 2010, in Mississippi. And we are able to probably reach that person. It's been a while, but that's what's going on in the USA. And once I started, and saw there were 21, through the activism and support from other concerned citizens, we actually have had it closed out of Ohio, and that was in 2009. And also out of New Mexico, which was in 2011, April 6th. I flew to New Mexico the last week. It was a bill that was introduced February 2011, and Governor Susana Martinez was not signing that bill. The primary targets of school beatings in the state of New Mexico are children who are Latino and Native American, and here Ms. Susana Martinez was failing to sign it. We faxed her so much that we literally burned out her fax machine, and on the day before the bill was to expire, she signed it. So this is to encourage people that activism does work. They have to hear you eventually, and we are not to give up, especially not to give up on our children who are being beaten and harmed, some fatally, right before their classmates. So, Kevin, if you wanted to ask a question, go right ahead.
I was going to just jump in quickly, Paula, because you can probably hear that annoying popping sound.
Yes.
If you would scroll down to the bottom of your chat room, below where you type your message, and see the speaker icon and click that. That will shut that noise off for you and for everybody else. And just a quick shout out to the Fixer is in the chat room with us, and he's been very supportive of this show and hacksradio.com. So welcome to the show, Fix, and I know you look out for the kids as well. But Paula, I got to say, though, when you had said your first instance in Alabama, that would have also been Kevin's first instance of assault on somebody.
Because I
can't even, I'm still almost in disbelief at what you brought to us, 19 states. I'm still trying to fathom that.
My daughter is going to try and help get that clicking sound off, because I'm not seeing a little speaker as you're referring. I think our windows are different, but she's going to try to help with that. Could you tell her what she should be looking for? It's right here, Nia.
Okay,
Kevin?
Near the bottom of the page on the Voice of Humanity page in the chat room area there, just below where you type. Do you see where you type and your cursor is flashing?
Yes,
okay,
I do.
Directly below that, there's a small icon that looks like a speaker, or maybe it looks like something really weird.
Found it.
Okay, there you go. You should be all set. Sound free. It'll probably ask you if you want to remember that setting, so that's up to you. But Yeah. Yes. So while you're talking, though, I'm going to go around and gather. I just put the link to your message board on your website in there, and I want to go over and get the link to your Facebook and all that stuff, too, so for the listeners. And, folks, if you're just getting here and think you missed anything, don't worry. Archives will be available as soon as possible. And if you are listening to this on the YouTube archive, any of the links that we shared during the live show will be down below in the Share More. And please hit that remix button. Get this information that Paul is getting you out. We need to get this country behind her, parents awake, and we need to rectify this. So, but continue on, Paula, because, you know, this is your level of expertise, and I'm learning. I'm still in awe at the fact that we even have to talk about this in this day and age. But
It's very sad. And the thing is that just so that your listening audience may know, the website message board that Kevin posted, if you go and click on that, I have a message there entitled Kevin M. Allen Paula Flo interview. It's right at the top. If you're driving and you want these links, some of them are posted there, and Kevin will also post additional ones. So I just want you to even follow along by looking at that. But just to move on forward here, one of the things is also is that I did grow up in Queens, New York City. As a matter of fact, part of my childhood was growing up in the same community with Martin Lawrence. And also my mom went to school with Larry King, of Larry King Live. And we are reaching out to people of their stature, of their visibility, to get this word out. And so those who are listening, the bottom line right now is that since the start of this work, again, September 11, 2006, the focus has been on gaining a U.S. federal protective bill for our American school children. And see, this is the thing that people want to recognize. During the time of slavery, the master was able to do whatever he pleased to the slaves. He could take them and send them off. He could violate them in any way, shape, or form and corporally punish them, which is nothing more than pain-based behavior management, basically, using a wooden board. And the way that the society would respond was, well, they're slaves. You're allowed to do that. And that is exactly the status of American school children. Now, Kevin and I are probably in the same age frame. I was born in the 50s, and there wasn't a U.S. federal protective law honored by our American educators when I was a little girl. However, we must keep in mind that our days are very different. In modern-day America, where our children are being abused, it is by no means for the good of their childhood development. Our children are under attack. And every American citizen who is listening to what I am saying, if you have a child attending a USA school, they have no more rights against abuse and even fatal harm than did a slave on old slave masters plantation. This fight for this bill is because we are living in times that are okay. I'm going to be posting this on my message board. I don't have this web link yet, but they actually have made waterboarding legal. And if you're not familiar with that, go to Wikipedia, just type in waterboarding, and it's sort of like a dry drowning. They are able to lay kids down, and I will post that, and torture them in this way. Also, electroshock therapy is becoming legal in our states. Massachusetts is one of the states where this is already out of control. They use what they call zappers. So where teachers are unable to use wooden boards to strike the children in the other 31 states, children are being subjected to other horrifying things. And some people might be like, oh my gosh, I can't imagine that happening at my school. Well, you know what? Maybe it is not happening at your school, but it's happening in this time, in this generation, to children who will be sharing this world with your safe children. And your children are only as safe as they can be with these children who are being abused left unleashed upon them. Because this is by no means anything more than anybody watching Kevin Allen's material, we're definitely under attack. They want to depopulate us. And so how else do you do that other than having lots of people to choose to go commit heinous crimes? I have a mom that I'm in touch with in one of the U.S. paddling states, and I will be presenting an interview that I held with her. They kidnapped her kids. Kidnapping children is popular and growing more so now. And we have a blow-by-blow account of what's going on, and she needs help, and she's one of many. The thing that is paramount that listeners understand is that the wooden board is the Pandora box to all of the physical abuse occurring in American schools. And when it happens in our schools, which is the higher standard, of course it's going to happen in the home, and you're going to have your sex trafficking, and you're going to have a variety of things that are going on in the community. Now, were you going to say something?
Yeah, I just wanted to give a little input. You had mentioned, the parent comment about, I can't imagine it happening at my school. And the reality is that there shouldn't even be the option. Now, maybe it's not happening, but all it takes is that one kid that pushes that one teacher a little too far, and the teacher has this knowledge that they can do that, and then so they will, if it reaches that extreme. So they shouldn't even have the option. Whether they're doing it or not, to me, is irrelevant. The fact
exactly.
that they're allowed to, and maybe they even use that as a psychological manipulation, as a threat. You know,
yeah. Constant.
Yeah, and that's probably worse than the physical part of it.
Yes, it is, and these parents, a lot of people say, well, Paula, you know, why are you working so hard on this? Why don't their own parents take care of them? And, you know, that's really sad, and it just shows how out of touch people are with this issue, because that would be like saying to the slaves, you know, why don't you guys free yourselves?
Right.
They're picking on people who have no money. It doesn't matter if you're a poor black kid or a poor white kid in Mississippi. If we can get you in one of our privatized prisons by beating the crap out of you till you drop out and commit a crime, that's where we want you to be. And so the privatized prison industry makes more money per child per day than the school system. So there's a whole nother, which I won't even go into, for this whole pipeline to prison issue. So people are not realizing that those who are receiving the brunt end of this practice and now with schools are those who have no money, have poor education, can barely articulate themselves, even if they just wanted to go explain to a doctor an illness they're having. If you visit our website, thehittingstopshere.com, and click on YouTube in the left, we have over 170 YouTubes, and some of them you could hear the parents, and their English is so poor. How on earth could you protect yourself? Language is the key to being able to communicate and to free yourself. So that's who they're getting. Our U.S. government, they are such bullies that they're saying, okay, let's get the poor kids. And they're making everybody poor, so that's easy to do in 19 states. So they're getting them all set up, and they're doing what is known as coon hunting. Even if you're white, if you're poor, you're Latino, you're Native American, we can coon hunt you, create a situation that we can have you put in one of our privatized prisons. You'll make 17 cents an hour on our $200 items. And our schools are the first place where protective needs are in order for establishing, because if America is willing to sit back and hear and learn and know that more than 2,000 reports of children being beaten occur a day, every 4 minutes, to the point where emergency medical treatment is needed, some of which fails, And so we lose children in our American schools, which you'll never hear on CNN or Fox or any of those. And if you did hear something, you're going to hear about that the kid did something. And this way you feel like, oh, good, they got one of them. You know, that's really what the news's goal is, to make sure you feel good about it if you do hear about a child being killed in our schools. But the thing is that at the end of the day, there is zero justice for these more than 2,000 cases of abuse. There won't be any mental health services available to them. And what happens when you're depressed and you have no money, you have poor health, you become an easy target for anything, any agenda that is set up. You know, they want you to help with this booming pharmaceutical industry because they're trying to make sure everybody is under the influence of at least 16 pills. Well, they need worker bees for that. And how do we get you in there to make these pills where we get everybody under the influence of some cocktail of drugs to keep them under all the time? Well, we need worker bees. And so the thing that's so clear and obvious is that I have YouTubes where Twitter has interrupted and tried so hard to get me off. And I recorded all the interruptions and put it on YouTube. And I said, I will not be bullied. And so now I get my message through. But it's really sad to see Facebook and Twitter, YouTube, not as extreme anymore. I'm really getting it all out there without a lot of interruption. However, had I been a cowardly person, I would have been off by now, the way that they were aggressively attacking my First Amendment online communication.
Yeah, so, it's horrible. I think now they have loosened up because, you know, especially Facebook has come under fire. And they also really, government programs are in hyper mode to collect data. So they allow, you know, you're probably, the reason they're letting you post so freely, Paul, is because you're in their sites, they don't like you, and they want to siphon as much information out of you as possible. That's what I see, that's what I assume. Yeah. You know, and that's a good thing because you're absolutely right. We got to get in their face. I mean, you know, some of my local friends that here in New Hampshire are pretty rural, and there's not a lot of activism, and it's not in the upbringing, you know, and some of the cultural interactions lacking or whatever. But a lot of my friends now that I've returned, why do you put so much time into this, and what are you going to do about it? And you know, and why are you, why? And you know, I look at you, look at what's going on. You don't have a clue about what's going on in your world, how toxic anything is, how much danger your kids are in, how fragile your feeble little world is. So I just keep hammering them with facts, and they're actually, you know, you got to, but it's like that's the attitude that got us here, you know?
Yes, exactly.
To hell with it, I can't change it, or to hell with it, let somebody else worry about it. But, you know, when it comes to the kids, I mean, people wake up. This is our leaders, our next workforce. You know, we can't have this. We can't have it. And you're absolutely right. Dealing with the public schools, you know, that's a horrible thing too with the kids. They help indoctrinate the kids into that whole mentality that this is okay. And I haven't had to deal with any abuse issues, spanking or whatnot with public schools, but on many other levels, I've had to horrify them with facts until they just shut up and their jaws dropped because they couldn't refute the facts, like vaccine stuff and other things, you know, the radiation issue and all this stuff. They just become silent. But good for you. Get in their face. Absolutely. Get in their face.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm glad they're listening. And people always say, don't you think they're watching you? And I say, you know what? I'm watching them. They need to be watched.
Exactly.
And if you're not watching them, you are part of the problem.
Yeah.
Because that's what they thrive on, is that people are not paying attention. One thing that I would like to say, and this is something particularly to parents of school-age children, and it ties in exactly to what you just said, Kevin, that people have to wake up. Now, many people feel that I'm fighting a losing battle, but I am not fighting a losing battle at all. What the and they feel that my battle is a fight against the U.S. government. You know where my battle is, Kevin? My battle, if there's any battle at all, is against apathy of U.S. citizens. See, the government, everybody knows they're corrupt. We have a U.S. government that has been corrupted, okay? Corporate America is basically running the country. Then we have Congress, and then we have we the people. I'm sorry, in colloquial terms, corporate America, they're the pimps. You know, Congress, they're the whores. And the people, that's we the people. We're the Johns. And that's all there is to it. But this is the good news. The good news is that they have not succeeded in full swing here in taking over with the New World Order, that they're desperately trying to kick in. But it really isn't happening because it takes a lot to do such an evil thing. And, you know, fortunately, God's on the side of the kids, so he's not having it. But the thing that I want to tell people listening, and especially people who say, well, you know, we can't do anything about the government. I hear that all the time. But let me tell you this. We right now have a U.S. federal protective bill. It is called Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act. It was introduced to the 111th Congress by New York Representative Carolyn McCarthy under the pressure of our organization along with other people. And so we have a bill that was reintroduced June 29, 2010. It failed because we the people failed it, basically. It was reintroduced. Mark Echo of Echo Unlimited Products. Now, that's an American hero right there. Unfortunately, he was threatened for his activism for having school beatings banned. And so he has taken a quieter stand in the back. But Mark Echo is an American hero. And he helped have that bill reintroduced a second time. He went directly to Carolyn McCarthy, said, please introduce it again. And she did. Now, that bill, we had almost 2 years to get through. And I campaigned almost an entire year. I was in Washington, D.C. and Minnesota, the state of our U.S. Education Committee chairman, John Klein. So I was at his office. Then he'd go to Washington. I was in Washington. He'd go back to Minnesota. I was in Minnesota. So from September to December, I was on this man who's called a U.S. education leader for having this bill signed. And on December 7th, I was on the steps of the U.S. Supreme Court, and there was a cameraman there interviewing me on this issue. And I said to him that if John Klein walks out of his office next week, the 14th of December, without signing that bill, something very big and very bizarre is going to happen, because he will see that we the people really don't care about our children to any meaningful degree. So it was December 14th that he walked out of his office, and that was the day of the Connecticut shootings. So 1 week before the shootings is exactly to the day that I said by December 14th, something big and bizarre will happen then or thereafter, because we are signaling, and this is their goal, to take our children out, to either hurt them, torture them, and turn them into people that would be more than willing to get some nice science uniform on and instill RFID chips in our children, because they're so damaged that, wow, you get a great job, we're going to make you a doctor, or, you know, whatever they do to have them comfortable with doing that. So it is extremely important that listeners out there know that if you want to point the finger at our government and say they're too big, we can't do anything, you must keep in mind that we have a 14th Amendment protective bill. See, the U.S. Constitution isn't a bunch of laws. They are amendments, and they are laws, but they are laws protecting our God-given human rights. Okay? The states have powers, but the Constitution is a body of laws that protect our human rights. And as long as we act like, oh, well, they're taking so many of our rights away, well, we aren't being good shepherds of our Constitution. The government is the executive, judiciary, and congressional branches, but in addition to those three is the body of we the people, which outnumbers them by millions. And so we have this big body of people who all they have to do to show the government you will not mess with our U.S. Constitution. Why not start out by protecting the children by making a phone call and saying, John Klein, we want ending corporal punishment passed into law to protect our school children. And if you don't do that, you are committing treason, and we will see to it that you are ousted from your position. I mean, that's treason. John Klein swore in on oath to uphold the U.S. Constitution, and would anybody out there contact him and say you want a copy of it, what he swore in, what he signed. And if he is failing to do that, like any other governmental official is failing to uphold the U.S. Constitution, we the people have the right to have them put in jail for committing treason. That's the name of that story. One of the things that I've been getting flooded with, and I bet you are too, Kevin, is the Newsweek on President Obama, his hidden homosexual life. That's shocking news. Raise your hand out there if you were shocked about that. And if you don't have that information, it is on our website message board that Kevin posted, 5 articles on it. But the fact of the matter is, if we're living in a country under a president who we're still wondering about his birth certificate. Now we're hearing that he had a homosexual life before being in a prearranged marriage to Michelle Obama so that he could take on presidency and dupe us into the conditions that we are in now. Then his NDAA and his NDRP are invalid because he's an invalid president. And so we need to know these things. So a lot of people think, well, you know, they're taking away the Constitution. Well, it's being replaced with the NDAA and NDRP. Are you going to sit back and let that happen? Or will we unite and preserve this country for our progeny? That's really the only choices. We could either sit back and say, oh, look at the government. They're so mean. Look what they're doing to us. They took away our rights. They could take our kids. They could put a shot in them. They could have moms, you know, have abortions now. Forced abortions are happening now. All sorts of things are happening. And we're sitting back pointing our finger instead of saying, that's treason. John Klein, you either sign the bill or get out of office.
Well, President you're Obama, absolutely. Yeah.
Show us your certificate. And uphold the Constitution by extending American. See, we don't even need the Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act. We really don't. That's one of their distractors, but we're going after it. All the Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act is a federal bill that mimics the 14th Amendment, the protective right. Our American school children are having their 14th Amendment protective and due process rights violated, and they're saying, well, you know, we got to beat them if they don't listen, so we're just trying to do the right thing. No, you're not. You're violating their 14th Amendment right, and you're making us go after some bill that we really do not need if you would just uphold the Constitution and extend them their 14th Amendment. But we will play this game until there are enough people playing it who could say, well, okay, we get it. Give our children their 14th Amendment protective right and due process right so they can have judicial relief when teachers approach them to cause the variety of harm that they are sanctioned to cause our children today.
You know, and that applies across the board. We need people standing up and holding these politicians accountable and you know, informing. Most people don't even know what their constitutional rights are. So I want to give a plug quickly to Op July 4th. There's a mass campaign to get people, and you can go to, I believe it's opjuly4th.com. Don't quote me. I'll try to find the link and put it below, but you can get constitutions. We want people handing them out. Inform people. You're right. People don't. I don't know if it's fear, if it's laziness, it's probably a combination of factors, fluoride in the water. But you got to stand up. And I did notice on your site that you had a petition. I did put the link to that in the chat room to ban the corporal punishment in public schools. So hopefully people will get on board with that. You know what we have though now, Paula, and it's very encouraging. And I'm trying to get mainstream people to wake up to the anonymous movement, because the propaganda has them labeled as evil hacker, just like you and I are terrorists. It's the same thing. You know, anybody that stands up for your rights now is a terrorist. They want people to not act anonymously. They don't want people to come together. So that's kind of one of the things I like to do is remind people that we have the internet, we have the entire planet, we have humanity. Some of the people that work as activists do have hacking skills, and those might be afforded to certain causes at certain times, but we have each other. We can share information, and we can make things go viral in minutes, and this is an issue that needs to go viral, and people need to get on this. You know, and I got to give a shout out just to the younger generation. I'm 42, almost 43. The younger guys, the mid 20s, because and even younger. I see them just getting so active, doing what I should have done 20 years ago, doing what you know my generation should have done, gotten off their asses and taken whatever means necessary. And these kids don't have guns, but they have the internet, and they're accomplishing things again that I should have done, my generation should have done. So shout out to the younger generation. You know, and I want people to pull together and you know, start doing some activism anonymously. But also you've got to remember that not everyone can be anonymous, because we need to put our faces to this. We need to stand up and say, I'm Kevin Allen, an American citizen, and I've had enough of your BS. By the way, there is a link, folks. If you go to my website, masterofmanythings.com, it's all over YouTube, there is a link to a petition to arrest and impeach Obama. He must be arrested first and impeached later. Impeachment takes too long. He needs to go now. That's my opinion, but you can find that. That's available. You know, I don't care what anybody's sexuality is or whatever. I like truth, you know, and I want our kids protected, certainly. You know, and Paul, I think I had recommended to you to reach out to members of the Op Liberation Group. I know that some of them are listening in tonight, and others will listen in through the archives, but on Twitter. They're fighting, you know, the kind of the same aspect from the institutional abuse. But if I had to guess, I think many of them are unaware that what you're talking about is going on in the public schools. And I see that movement possibly helping your movement, because it seems like you're doing, I don't understand why there aren't 100 of you, Paula. Why did I just hear about this last week? Why don't I know about this?
Well, yeah, I'll tell you one thing, Kevin, that's very surprising to me, that although there are a number of activists who profess to want children's rights, the National Youth Rights Association, they haven't embraced this issue. And there are so many. In fact, on our message board, there is a link that says other organizations who profess to want school corporal punishment banned. And their voices are missing from this whole thing. And earlier you made a point that perhaps people are afraid of the government and blah, 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 about, you know, I want to stay hidden and invisible. Well, that isn't true, and it was proven in January of 2012 with the SOPA issue over the internet, where the government was threatening to take down Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube. Anything that said anything against the government was going to become illegal, which would have taken my movement completely out, because it's all about the government. So a bunch of us actually came together, and we all, before we knew it, the U.S. government was receiving more than 800,000 tweets a day and emails saying, you know, don't mess with our First Amendment, don't mess with our online First Amendment. And we kept on, and until that bill that they were trying to sign to take away this opportunity, you and I wouldn't even be on this right now if it were not for that fight in January 2012.
It was won.
So it makes me say, well, if people are so afraid of the government, they weren't afraid when they were going to take their Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook. They were very verbal out there.
Well,
you talk about these children, and where is everybody? for the next generation of this great nation? That's what I want to know.
Well, I think the percentage is low. I see a lot of people starting to wake up and more people getting active, which is very encouraging. But I think if you could, you know, have an exact number of people that are active on any level, you know, and just speaking out and being active, and then you compared that to the population, I think it's sickening. Because things are so drastic. When we're talking about our kids being beaten in a public school, still being allowed, that everybody, and I can't understand why at least 75% of the people in this country wouldn't immediately hear that, go to their school, say, listen, you put your hands on my kids, I'm going to put my hands on you, I don't care what your written law says. And then they would proceed from there to the governor's office or whoever and say, listen, this law exists, you better wipe it out or I'm going to put my hands on you next. I've had enough. You're not doing this. Why?
I don't understand. I mean, I posted yesterday about how our pregnant girls, you could be 7 months pregnant and they will have you bend over and they will beat you. Because where these children are, they're so entrenched in this backwardness and these people are such tyrants over them. They tell their parent, if we don't hit them, we're going to put you in jail because you're interrupting with proper care and raising of your child. So they get threatened and they're ignorant. They have no money. And they are throwing some in jail for not allowing the teachers to beat them. And here I'm posting about girls 17, 15, 5, 6, 7 months pregnant being beaten by our big male teachers, and I got maybe 2 likes. Not that I'm trying to get likes, but it just is an indication of the level of interest that even pregnant girls doesn't matter for anybody to respond to. And I want to make sure that it's clear also regarding President Obama's exposed homosexual life that's starting to go rampant out there online is that it's not an issue of him being homosexual or not being homosexual. What the issue is that he had a prearranged marriage, which is deception. He was living a lifestyle that is hidden. And all of a sudden, it's sort of like there's this thing, this big exposure of, okay, we don't have your birth certificate. You were living this life. You didn't know Michelle. You two were brought together. She was perfect because she just likes perks, and you were going to be her ticket to perks forevermore, and you were going to get to take the country down. If anybody hasn't seen Obama's America 2016, that's a must for every family that's concerned about the future of this country. His dreams are his father's dreams, and his father's dreams were not for the American dream to thrive, the dream that the forefathers of this country had when they wrote the U.S. Constitution. So we have this big hidden thing now being exposed, and Mitt Romney and Obama wanting to double the size of Guantanamo Bay instead of returning these poor suffering U.S. citizens to their families and their loved ones. They haven't had any trial, and you want to make a bigger prison now? So it's sort of like there's all of this hidden stuff. We trusted him. We were excited. We're like, wow, America's awesome. They voted in a black man. And we must really be moving on. And then we find all of this this hidden agenda stuff and America taking a nosedive while kids are being abused and murdered. And I don't know if I mentioned this to you, Kevin, but our American educators can take kids now, and we have cases. We're having an event April 27th and also May 18th. That's on the message board, too, is awareness at events. Teachers are taking kids, and they can actually put them in a basket hold and suffocate them. The kid dies. And what? The teacher's allowed to just go teach someplace else. That happened 2008, a black special ed boy. He had a fear of being hungry. The teacher wouldn't let him eat, and it was 2 in the afternoon. He was panicking because his parents used to withhold food from him, so he had a disorder about food. And she let him get wild and crazy looking for candy in the desk and all over the place. And she took him in front of his classmates, and this 239 teacher took this 119-pound kid, bent over him until he breathed his last. And the judge, when she was taken to court, said that was homicide. Have a good life. Because teachers are protected, when they hurt your children even fatally under what are known as teacher immunity laws under the no intention to cause harm gambit. So it's all lock, stock, and barrel. If your kid hasn't been abused or their life is still intact, great. But if it did happen, mom, dad,
this 119
you don't have any judicial relief for your child. And this bill, Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act, is a bill for protecting your child by U.S. federal law, which the 14th Amendment is supposed to do.
I don't understand how we can even get away. It just still kind of knocks my mind around that we're even having this discussion. People can suffocate your kids and die and have immunity and then just continue to do it?
Yes, yes. And there are other things burgeoning. The waterboarding, I just urge everybody to really learn what that is and see what they're doing now, to our children.
I want to just take a quick second, if I could,
sure.
Paula, because every time I get an opportunity to call out Alex Jones, and you and I discussed this last night, I'm going to do it, and I was going to not do this, but if we have this going on, our children are being killed in the public schools, and as you mentioned in private conversation last night, he has not addressed this.
Yes, indeed, you're correct. I've written Alex Jones. I've even gone to his office in Texas, and I've sent him money, and I've said, please, please, tell the people you have a following. And what I saw was that he responded with parents, because what I said was, part of the message was, teachers can beat the kids, but the parents can go to jail if they do so, which is true. And sometimes they don't. If it's a benefit for them to put you in jail, they will. If it's not, then you don't go to jail. But the bottom line is Alex's Jones' response was, parents could hit their kids if they want to. That was it. That was all the support I got from him, was telling him that kids could be abused and murdered, and tell Ron Paul, Rand Paul, the Dalai Lama, all of these folks have been informed. I have been in all of their faces. Rand Paul is on the Education Committee on the Senate of the present 113th Congress. I've already contacted him, and they're like, he's too busy to respond to me. So the bottom line is that Ron Paul, Rand Paul, Alex Jones, the Dalai Lama, all of these people have been informed of Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act, the deaths, the murders, the rapes, the torture, and the new forced medication, that if you don't give your kid medication, you're going to jail. All of these new laws, they've been informed. Why aren't they telling their huge followings?
Yeah, I really don't understand that. And I mean, I see Alex Jones and have since about the third month that I became aware of him. At first, I liked his stuff, thought, hey, this guy is onto something. But I didn't know anything about anything back then. Within 3 months, I could see the psychology, and I started doing research. And he's controlled opposition as far as I'm concerned. Because if you really think about it, the information he puts out is information that any of us could find anywhere. He uses routers. He uses the BB. He's not giving you anything new. You're rehashing the same things that we know have gone awry and that are going on. He's rehashing them every day. You're not finding out about your kids getting beaten in school. You're not finding out about the fallout from Fukushima. You're not finding out about any of the stuff. I'm trying to refrain the language, folks. I'm doing well, huh? You're not going to find out about any of the stuff that affects you right now. Now, I don't have a time machine, and yes, George Bush should be arrested, and yes, 9/11 is a lie, and yes, all that. I don't have a time machine to go back and fix that, but folks, what's right in front of us now is our kids getting beating. The mainstream media is not talking about it. The people that you think are truth seekers and freedom fighters and true patriots, they're allowing it. They know what's going on. Alec, you heard it. Paula's been doing this. She's out there.
Yeah, I went to his office.
That is just amazing. So any of you, I know I'll get some good YouTube comments from the trolls and the sheep that follow Alex like he's a god. And this will be awesome for me later because I love debate with, the psyop part of it. But, this is disgusting. I mean, the parents should be doing it. But then we think that, the media is kind of like our army, right, for the people. We can get the news, we can use the media to leverage situations and draw attention to things, and we're finding out the media is also under the control of the same corporations. You're not going to get the information that you need to know. You're going to get the information that they want you to know, you know, given to you in a way that they want you to view it. But I don't see how you could you can't sugarcoat a story like this, and I don't see how any, that's probably why it's not in the media. We can't spin this. We can't write a story that makes you think that this is okay. Thank God for UC What Jules. I've got to give Jules a shout-out. I think she's away from the home tonight, but Jules for putting this network together and Paul for supporting her in that. We here and all the hosts do the same thing. Push the limits and get this information out to you folks. So please share the links and everything on your YouTubes, on your Facebooks, your Twitters. Paula, do you have a Twitter account? That's the one thing I didn't get from you. And while you're continuing to talk, I'll go find that so that before we end the show, everybody has the link to your Twitter account as well.
Oh, sure. I'm going to send it to you right now, and then you can post it. And, you know, I can't emphasize it enough to your listeners. If you're going to put down the government and say they stink, they're terrible, and they're no good, you have to turn that finger and point at yourself, and you have to say, did I pick up a phone to make sure that the future of this nation, which is our children, are being protected? If we are failing to protect children from being abused and murdered, could we really imagine America being restored to greatness while our children are being abused and murdered in wide open view of our world? Our dollars are paying for it, and we have this big New World Order machine trying to come and take us out. You know, I mean, we do need God, and he calls the children the greatest. I cannot imagine God blessing America, and we get this nosedive course that we're on now, facing upward to victory, while at the same time cannot even pick up a phone. Everybody has a cell phone, and they're all over the phone. You see them on the train, the bus, and the car. Can you make a call to U.S. Education Committee Chairman John Klein and say, reintroduce Ending Corporal Punishment in Schools Act and have it pass into law as early as possible in 2013. If we get the kids protected, I can hardly believe that we will be unable to restore America to greatness. But it won't happen while our kids are being abused and murdered by their teachers.
We got to get everybody behind you on this, Paul. And please, folks, again, remix this video. Include the links if you're watching it on the archive. I'm just going to give you a time heads up, Paula, so you can kind of adjust yourself. And folks, again, don't worry. I believe, Paula, we're going to continue this next week because I know you have more information, and we've only got about 7 minutes left, so there's really not a lot of time for calls this show. But maybe next, you can be back next week, same time.
Oh, I would love to. And if I can, I actually wrote 7 facts that the average American is unaware of regarding USA school beatings. And it'll be real quick. Would I have enough time to do that?
Yeah, we've got about 6 minutes. I just want to let you know now. When you hear my introduction music start, I'm going to end the call immediately so that our next host, Kurt, can get logged into the system. So, folks, stay tuned. Kurt's got an awesome show for you coming up. But go ahead, Paula. We got about 6 minutes.
Okay. It'll take me less than that. Well, first of all, one of the 7 facts is that there are 0 standards for beating American school children. It doesn't matter. You could do it every day. You could do it 3 times a day. You could hit them as hard as you want, as many times. Kids are hit from 1 to 23 times per time that they're met with a beating in our schools. Number 2, some of the students, before they are going to be paddled, like to wear heavy clothes if they know it's supposed to happen the next day. Teachers take their hands and put their hands on their buttocks cheeks and squeeze them to see whether or not there's tissue in there or that sort of thing. So that's sexual molestation right there. And if they didn't have anything there, then they squeeze them and then they beat them. And if they did have, they either take it out themselves or they make the kid take it out. The other thing is that there is an organization called Parents Rights, okay? Parents Rights, and it's led by Reverend Michael Farris. Michael Farris is a menace to children in the USA and globally. If something says parents' rights, I will be posting. I believe I have a radio show on that issue. But let me tell you, parents' rights means that the government can hijack parents' rights. Okay, it is not in favor of mommy and daddy at all. Okay, so let's just, we'll get back to that. I want to make sure people aren't being duped by that. As a matter of fact, just to drive that point home, the people who are pushing parents' rights are legislators who could have signed the bill to end the school beating, such as Charles DeJew and a few others. So we have the names of the people who support parents' rights, which hurts you as a parent, and your rights will be taken from you. And those are the people who failed and were able to sign the bill to end USA school beatings. I think that says it all right there. The next thing is that the senator, anybody in the House or in the Senate, can reintroduce this bill. So no matter where you live, you can be the one to say, I am going to make sure that the senator or House rep of my state reintroduces the bill. Don't wait for Carolyn McCarthy. I'm after our Hawaii legislator, Mazie Hirono. She can introduce that bill, and she hasn't, and we will be rallying outside of her office throughout April and May until that bill is reintroduced. And also, the story behind school beatings is one that begins with the Willie Lynch letter and ends with the Black Wall Street occurrences that took place in the 1800s, and that's also on our message board. I'm going to make sure that anything that I mention is on our message board so you can go back and research yourself. I mentioned also that girls who are pregnant are beaten in American schools. And also, if a girl, I have received a letter from a 12-year-old girl who was on her cycle, and teacher beat her. And the reason why they beat American girls who are on their cycle or pregnant and not yet showing is because it is illegal to say, are you pregnant or are you on your cycle? So since they're not allowed to ask the question, they just go ahead and say, bend over, and they beat these children. So one girl wrote me on YouTube and said, I'm glad to see you're trying to bring this to an end, a little girl from Mississippi. She said, I had no idea that this wasn't going on in the whole country. She thought that every kid in America got beat for these things. And she told me that she was beat by her teacher because she was late to class, and her dad found out, and then he beat her. And she's on her cycle getting beaten by two men because she was late to class. That's the mentality we have.
This is incredible that a teacher can't ask if a young lady is having her period, but they can physically assault her. There's something very, very, yeah, very wrong in the world and it is happening, and that's why we're here.
It is happening.
That's ridiculous. Just a minute or two before we hear the music, Paula, but I want to remind everybody that we will be back here next week, next Wednesday, 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. to finish the information from Paula. It would be great in the meantime if we can, we'll try to allow some call time during that show and get some kids. If this has affected your life, or you know a kid or a parent that is going through this, to call in so that we can wake people up. It's one thing that Paula and I come and present information and try to inform you, but when you hear it from somebody it's happening from, that's powerful. So, folks, you have a whole week to share this information, set it on your schedule, reach your contacts. We need everybody's help behind us on this. We need everybody behind Paula. And, you know, maybe next week, Paula, you can also give us some tips, give the kids some tips on how they can protect themselves and parents, what type of action they can take. And I don't care what the law says, folks. I don't care. Yeah. You keep your hands off my kids. You keep your hands off my neighbor's kids. And we need to come at this with that type of attitude or this isn't going to stop. Because obviously you've been fighting for a while, Paula, very active. I see your post, and you're very active. You're trying to reach people. So everybody follow Paula. Share the event that I linked in the chat room. Please share that with all your contacts. That'll help. Share Paula's Twitter, the website. There we are. Much love, Paula. We'll see you next week.